Thank you, Jesus. I'm living this moment because of you. I want to thank you and I praise you too. Your grace and mercy brought me through. One last time. Your grace and mercy brought me through. I'm living this moment because of you. I want to thank you and praise you too. Your grace and mercy brought me through. I believe that song tonight is a reality in your lives. The Lord, your grace and your mercy brought me through. I'm living this moment all because of you. So Lord, I want to thank you and praise you too. Your grace and your mercy brought me through. Amen. Let me greet us tonight in the most holy and exalted name of Jesus. Let me greet those who have joined us by way of the internet. Amen. Out there. Amen. Have joined us. Amen. Good to have you with us tonight as we gather such together in the house of God in another study of the Word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. We greet those that are out there tonight in Orlando, PTA. Amen. Number 2. God bless you. Amen. I know you won't be joining us until after service tonight because you're also in Bible study. But whenever you join us, God bless you. Amen. God is a good God. And he deserves all our praises. Vanless Frederica Francis, God bless you. She asked me to greet the saints. Amen. For her tonight. Amen. Amen. And I'm greeting on behalf, amen, of Vanless Francis and Pentecostal Tabernacle Apostolic Number 2. Amen. Orlando, Florida. Amen. God is a good God. Hallelujah. And I greet you from PTA number 1 in Hartford, Connecticut. Amen. That sounds good. Amen. God is truly amazing. And we praise and we lift up his holy name. Amen. Is he good to you? Lord Jesus. Is he good to you? Let me ask. Is there a problem with this? That some of your mother's still locked up. Is he good to you? Yes. Hallelujah. Every chance I get to praise him, I'm going to praise him. He is a mighty, mighty, mighty good God. And we bless his holy name. Amen. I'm going to ask you behind it, fill up these for me, please. Nobody behind Deacon Kerr. Amen. Just fill up these and come forward. Amen. God bless you. Amen. 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 Let's see what the Lord have for us tonight. Amen. And last week, this time I was in Florida in Bible class. Amen. Amen. The schedule is same there as it is here. Amen. Amen. That's right. Amen. 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 That's right. Have the same DNA. Amen. Operate the same way. Amen. All right, it's no difference. Amen. Amen. We are one. Amen. Somebody flash it at me. Amen. But it's a good feeling. It's a good feeling. Amen. I'm excited tonight about what God is doing. All right, everybody. Amen. We've been talking. And we've been dealing with the governing elements in the saints' life. The governing elements in the saints' life. Amen. And that's the base scripture. That's where we're operating from. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 19 to 27. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 19 to 27. And I just want to read from the Word Bible. Amen. From the Word Bible. And Paul says, first sentence, for though I be free from all men, and the Word Bible reads this way, in this way no one has any claim on me. You got that? From the regular King James writing, it says, for though I be free from all men, that's how it starts, verse number 19. And in the Word Bible, it reads this way, in this way, no one has any claim on me. No one has any claim on me. In other words, I'm sold out to God. And he does what he wants. Amen. It does as it pleases him. So what I do must be based on what he says. And no one else has any claim on me. Amen. You see, in the secular world, amen, if you borrow money from the bank like in this house, amen, the mortgage, the bank has first claim on these properties. First claim. Amen. They're in first place. Anybody else come after them. But when it comes to God's business, when it comes to us, you and I, as people of God, he's first and he's last, because he's the author and he's the finisher of all faith. Thank you, Jesus. So Paul said, nobody, no one has any claim on him. So what he does, he's going to do it pleasing God. Amen. He's saying, I'm saying that he don't have to look to his left or to his right to see who agree and who don't agree. Amen. And what I do when it comes to God is not based on what Deacon Bury thinks or says. It's based on what God says. Amen. So we have to get that at the very beginning, that nobody has got any claim on us. Amen. So therefore, he has a right to establish what? Talk to me. Governing elements. He has all right to establish governing elements on or in our lives. He has the right to tell us how he wants us to live, what he wants us to do. And not even you have a claim on you. Did you know that? So when we start to dictate and tell God what we're going to do from what we're not going to do, we're out of place. We are out of line. When we decide I'm going to do this and I won't do this, I'm going to do it as I please, back up. The book says we are not our own. Are you going to help me? That we have been bought with a price. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We are owned by somebody. We are owned by God. Therefore, whatever we do must be based on the instructions that he gives us. Whether we like it or not, whether we agree or not, we are expected to do what he says. Like I say, he has the right to establish the boundaries. How we live. Amen. How we walk here from earth to eternity. All right. unteachable, rebellious, stubborn, self-willed attitudes spell ultimate doom. It's up there so you can read it. Unteachable, rebellious, stubborn, self-willed attitudes spell ultimate doom. Ask the person beside you. Are they talking about you? And what are they talking about me? Unteachable. Because some of us know so much that we can't be taught. Hello? Some of us are so knowledgeable because God had to clear it with us first. So anything that anybody else says, it really does not amount to anything. As a matter of fact, I know more than the teacher. Hello? That's right. I am more knowledgeable than the teacher. So therefore, I don't have to accept what he says. Because what he says, there's no truth to it. As a matter of fact, the Lord gave me the interpretation. He revealed to me how it goes, how it ought to be done. So what is being said is not true. Unteachable, rebellious, pushing back. Refuse to accept what God says. And we need to understand, before he says it, he doesn't do a survey to find out how you're going to react. This is not based on the polls that people do. Are you going to help me? Amen. He doesn't do opinion polls. He doesn't find out what you're thinking. He doesn't try to find out what your beliefs are. Come on. He doesn't want to find out whether you agree with him or not. He is God. And he's going to say as it pleases him. And he knows what we need to do in order to get ourselves right when it comes to the things of God. Hello? Rebellious. I refuse to accept anything that is said from that pulpit. Because, you know, he's dumb. Hello? Help me, Jesus. Lord, I wish I could do something in here tonight. I wish I could do something right here. I'm going to do it. Brother Jeremy, I know her eyes are closed. Oh, no. She's awake. Come in, sweetie. Send her here for me, Sister Asher. Send her here. Come in, darling. Come in. Come, Pastor Collier. Come here 1 minute. Come quickly. Come in, sweetie. Come on. Not going to do anything. I love you. You feel all right? Yeah. Pastor, love you. Come in. I'm not going to drop you, darling. I'll demonstrate something. I'm holding her in my hand. Wisdom would tell her, I don't need him. I can stand right where I am without him. Will you help me? I can do without feet from where I am. I really don't need him. You get the message? If I lose her, she drop. In order for her to be where she is right now, I have to be holding on to her. She's in my arms. Is that right? I'm holding her in my arms. So she needs me. Talk to me, somebody. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. It is dumb. Thank you, darling. And a lot of times we think that way. I wish I had some help. Do you wonder why some of us are stumbling? Do you know why some of us, we are butting our heads and our toes? Then some of us are having such a difficult time in doing the things that God said that we ought to do. Because we have gotten to a place that we think, I don't need. So I have the right to do what I feel like. But the Bible says, we're going to get to that. I'm just getting ahead a little bit. That the people can't hear. I don't care how much you study. I don't know how much you think you know. There are some things you don't know. God is too wise. Hello, somebody. And he has established a way in which we are to do what must be done. His method of what? Proven, but what we didn't hear. It's a method of what? The elements has put in place to govern us. Thank you. And anytime we start to act like we don't need leadership, trust me, tonight we're bound to drop. You know, certain things. You are bound to fail. You are bound to mess up. Hello, are you with me? Come on, somebody. Everybody needs somebody. Stubborn. Are we talking about church folk? Yes. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing that. I'm not doing the other. I don't see it that way. You're not supposed to. You're not God. Because God's way is different from our way. Is that what the word of God says? His thoughts, he don't think like us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. And I'm going to say this. God makes demands to humble us. Let me say it one more time. He makes demands. He's put some stuff in place in order to humble us. Because too many times we think we're bigger than God. Hello? Stick with me, saints. Self-willed. I don't care what God says. I don't care what the preacher says. I've got my own way of seeing this. I've got my own way of doing this. Amen. And I don't see the way he says. Because the Lord is showing me something different. Well, trust me tonight. I'm going to help some of you in here. Anytime God is showing you something different, what he gives the leader, it means God don't need a leader, he need you. You never say anything. Anytime God shows you something different, what he shows his servant that he put in place to pass on information, it means he has rejected who is talking to you. Hello? It means it's time for you now to be elevated. Help me, Jesus. It's no time for you to be in the position of pastor. Because what God is saying to you, you know what he's saying to the one who he put in place. So somebody's making a mistake. That self-will, those self-willed attitudes, it spells trouble. Amen. I don't know why we think we know what's best for us. Because if it was left to us, we would mess up from pillar to post and put ourselves in glory. You know, I'm speaking the truth. If it was left up to me, I wouldn't do nothing right. No, I'm sorry. I'm the only one. Because look like it's a lot easier to do wrong. It's effortless. You don't have to fight anything. You just do it. Oh, I'm the only one again. I don't have to think about anything. I don't have to think about any consequences. I just do it. But if I'm going to think about doing something that I ought not to, it means something is happening. Is that right? That's right. It means something is happening. Something's telling me you have no right. You don't have no right to do what you want to do. It means God is speaking. How many times have we fought off the voice of God? How many times have we pushed him aside? I'm going to do it my way. I don't care what they say. Think I'm going to listen to him. Please. Hello? Amen. Sometimes we do it even for the better. But to take on any of these attributes right here, it spells ultimate. Ultimate means final. You hear me? Final doom. We might be speaking in tongues tonight. We might be teaching tonight. We might be shouting tonight. But it's not based on that. Hello? My eternal future is not based on any of that. It's obeying what God says from his word. And if I push back on the things that he put in place. Hello. There's a reason why there are guidelines. There are reasons why there are rules and regulations. Because you know that I know that you know. God, we would beat God if we catch him. Hello, somebody. Amen. This house will be a total mess. Thank you, Lord. Doing what we feel like doing our way. Was that Sammy Davis? I know. That's why y'all are listening to them stuff. Frank Sinatra. I did it my way. But hear me tonight saying, when you do it your way, you're going to get you in trouble. It spells ultimate doom. It spells final separation from God. That's what it means. And I'm going to say this tonight. I'm not going to act like a fool to find out what the pastor, the preacher, teacher said was really true. I now want to live to prove anything to anybody. Because guess what? I'm going to have to deal with it on the other side. Unteachable, rebellious, stubborn, self-willed attitudes spells ultimate doom. You don't want to go there. No, you don't. Guidelines are necessary for ones to survive. Spiritually, guidelines are necessary. You can say the talk, I don't see the importance of this. Like a lot of us love to say. I don't see why. Hello? Because you see, we think we have to see everything. Thank you, Lord. I've got to be in a position to figure everything out. Don't bring your analytical minds into God's stuff. Let me say it again. Don't bring your analytical minds into God's business. Don't try to analyze what he's saying. You and I don't have the right to do it. We are not equipped to do it. Because we sing the song, he's so high. He's so wide. He's so deep. So go ahead and analyze. Go ahead. Hear me tonight. If men are still trying to figure out God's creation. Hello. Are you with me? If men are still trying over these many centuries to figure out God's creation, can't you understand something? There had to be somebody greater than the creation. And if you can't figure the creation out, how are you going to figure out the creator? It's impossible. Hello? So guess what? We might as well accept what the creator says and do what he says do. Because our minds are not equipped and developed enough to do the job what you want to do. Amen. Hello, somebody. Let me help us tonight. The Bible says, Evangelist Michael, we know in part. We preach in part. Everything we do it in part. Because we are restricted by this. This is sinful. So you can't absorb all of God. You can't understand him. Because this is not equipped to do the job. But he's given us enough to get us from here to glory. Come on, somebody. He's given us enough for us to understand. The little bit that we can is to get you from here to glory. Hello. Bless the name of Jesus. It is important for us to understand what God says from his word. So guidelines are necessary for one to survive spiritually. Grace doesn't authorize us to be loose. Put that word there. To be loose. Put a B there. To be loose. And pursue our own desires and ways. Let us all read that because I think we all need to read it. What does it say? So when we don't want any form of restrictions, hello. When we don't want to be told, because some of us don't want to be told what God says. We don't want to be told what to do. Hello. Pastor is going on as if he's a dictator. Hello. Thank you, Jesus. That's right. Amen. Acting as if he's my boss. And what he says we have to do. Well, guess what? I don't have to do what he says. Woo! It is sad to say that some of us are going to be shouting straight down to hell. Speaking in tongues straight to the lake. And I'm not talking Lake Michigan. Our Lake Erie. Our Lake Quasi down here. It's in Connecticut. I'm not talking that. We're not going to the amusement park. Hello, somebody. There's a reason why. Because God knows if he don't put guidelines on us, we're going to do all that we feel like. And expect him to accept it. It doesn't matter how much God plead with some of us. We're not moving. And I watch some of us. We're not budging. Hello? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. But if we're going to survive spiritually, it means some of us are dying and don't even know it. To survive spiritually, it comes with godly guidelines. It comes with godly restrictions, hello, and godly instructions. It comes with that. If you can get paid and don't work, tell me you're going to work. Come, talk to me. Come on, let's go. If you can sleep all day and all week and just go to the bank because it was payroll deductible, so it's gone to the bank, would you go to work? Don't want to lie. Oh, I just love to work. You know you're lying. You don't go because you have to. It's necessary, or else you don't have the money to get. That's why you go. I just love what I do. Yeah, you present a way to you. You can get paid and don't work and see what you do. You're still going. You're not going on a job. Just like this man, naturally, that will not pay us if we don't work. Have no pay to get. What do we take God for? A fool? Think again. So if I want to be paid, at the end of the day, I better work right. And the man in the secular world, he don't want his work or whatever he does, his business crashing. So he sets guidelines. And if we think we're going to do what we feel like, and God going to pat us on the back and say, welcome, you keep up that junk. You keep it up. Like I say many times, you don't have to believe it. You don't have to accept it. Just keep on doing the stupid stuff you've been doing. You'll find out. So to survive spiritually, I need some guidelines in my life. Hello. Check Saul. Check Saul. Why don't you talk to him? Hello. I'm going to see if I can find the address and give it to you. But Saul thought he didn't have to follow the guidelines laid down by the man of God. Listen, God didn't talk to Saul direct. I want to help some of you in here. Because whenever God, you want to go to your bed and get a dream, and get a vision. The Lord spoke to me in my bed last night. He's talking right now. And you're not asleep. You're very much conscious. Hello, it might be a nightmare you are having. You're not having a nightmare now. He's speaking audibly so you can hear. And he's speaking clear that you can understand. Hello, somebody. Amen. That in order to survive, God has put rules in place to keep us in check. We are Adam's children. Hello, God, not dumb. But Brother Saul thought he had the right. I'm king Saul. Yeah, the Lord chose me or called me to be king over all Israel. I hear what Samuel said, but guess what? Soldiers, we're not doing it that way. I heard what Samuel said. It's not going to be done that way. You're going to do what I tell you to do. Y'all here? Because I'm speaking. Hello. Samuel said, God says, kill everything. Destroy all. But I saw, say, no. Keep some. Come on. Keep back some because we're going to have a sacrifice. Y'all here? We're going to blow God's mind. Because he didn't expect us to offer sacrifice. We're going to keep this back. Let me help us tonight. God knows what he wants. You don't have to tell him. Amen. 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 It look like sometimes we think that we're going to tell God what he wants. He knows. He don't need you and I to tell him anything. But Saul did his stuff and thought he was home free. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. The battle is won. That's what the battle is won. We got the victory. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord. I know the Lord is going to be pleased tonight. I know there's going to be a big smile on Samuel's face when he hear that we won. Thank you, Jesus. I can just imagine when he stepped up to report to Samuel. Lord Jesus. Saul! What's that I'm hearing? What did God say? On whose authority did you do this? Who gave you instructions to do it this way? The last time I checked, this is not the way God said it ought to be done, was supposed to be done. But you made a choice to do it your way. Yes. Hear me tonight. Your way will always get you in trouble. Because your way is against God. Hello? So Saul talked to me. Did you kill? Yeah. That liar. Did you do what God said do? Yeah. So what's that? What's that? What am I hearing? I hear the goat. I hear the sheep. Come on. I forgot, Samuel, I forgot. You know, I told the men, we're going to offer sacrifice unto the Lord. What did God ask you for? One thing, obey. Hello. Bless the name of Jesus. Guidelines that he's put in place in order for us to make it in. We know the story. Samuel told him, because of what you did, and you did not obey what God says in his word, God has taken the kingdom from you. God help me tonight. It is a sad thing to be sitting in the throne but have no kingdom. Still sitting in the throne. Still occupy the office of king. But God said, listen, because of what you just did, what was yours is now taken from you. So don't let sitting in the throne fool you. Oh, help me, Jesus. Don't let sit in the house of God, in the city, sit down to that. Believe it, all is well. Have you been obeying God? Have you been following the guidelines that he's laid down in his word? Come on. Have I been rebellious? Have I been stubborn? Have I been a self-willed person and display certain attitude? Glory. Don't let your seed fool you. Don't let your tongues fool you. Hello, somebody. It's been in obedience to God and his word. That's what matters. Hello, somebody. And it is sad that many of us don't believe what God says. If we did, we would have done what he said do. But no, we don't. I'm going to prove to everybody that what the preacher says is a lie. Go ahead, honey. Go ahead. God's grace does not authorize us to be loose and pursue our own desires and way. You will think because we save and Holy Ghost feel I can make my own choices. Back up, sister. Back up, brother. It's our choice, but you're not free. You're not authorized to do what you want. Hello, I don't need this, I don't need that, I don't need the other. I can do it all by myself, on my own, I don't need nobody. Hello. You're not a free agent. No commitment to any one team, anybody wants to call you. Are you hearing me? God does not operate that way. Your loyalty is only supposed to be to him and nobody else or nothing else. And if we are loyal to him, we're going to do what he says do from his word. Thank you, Jesus. So, grace, and we think that, is your unmerited favor. Hello, I can do anything I want. And it's going to be all right. Hello? No. Grace is what rescued us. But it's not freedom for us to do what we want. Grace was what rescued us because we were supposed to die. We are not free unto us, so we are free unto God. Hello? How many of us have refused to follow the instruction? There was somebody that I know, and he goes to the store and buy anything that you put together. He's going to let you know, I don't have to follow the instruction. I know to do it. Is you make it? You must be the one that made it. You just came down from heaven. So you know the road from heaven to earth. So going back to heaven is just follow the same direction. Yeah. Talk to me. We've never been there. There are guidelines, there are rules, there are regulations to get us there. But this person, at the end of him putting, there are always some stuff left over. And I'm not talking spear. It means that stuff can never ever still get up for long. You know why? They did it their way. Because they thought they had the answer. I know how to do it. You don't know how to do it. I don't know. God knows. So it's best and wisdom will tell us to follow the instructions and the guidelines that are laid down. Or else you're going to miss it. Or else I'm going to miss it. I don't know about you, but I can't afford to miss it. Hello? This is what we said at the very beginning. Nobody owns me. That's what Paul said. Nobody owns me. Nobody have no jurisdiction over me but God. Hello? That's right, everybody. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. And I want you to know tonight, it's not me. It's God. I'm only his voice. Thank you, Jesus. So the voice you hear is God's voice. This is how we sound. You hear? You don't have to love the tone of his voice. But it's his voice. And they expect us to follow what he says. It is sad that many of us are on the road to destruction. And think we're on our way to a better day. Let me leave you. But we have no authority to be loose and to pursue our own desires and ways. Disciplines. Controls. Guidelines. Teachers and instructors are the order of God's kingdom. Hello, faint, no faint. Pass out, everybody. Don't you just love that? Disciplines. Controls. Guidelines. Teachers and instructors are the order of God's kingdom. God's kingdom does have structure. Amen, Pastor. Let me ask you a question. If you care about your house, your home, where you live, have you any rules there? No. Have any guys down there? No. I need to follow some of your home today and just get in there and jump up and down all over the place. I'm going to find me some mud someplace and stick my foot in there. And find your pretty brand new clean carpet and step on it. I'm going to jump on the bed with my shoe on. Hello? You don't say, like, go ahead, Pastor, have fun. Hello? We don't do any of that. There are rules. There are guidelines. There are controls. There are disciplines in our homes. And God's house is no less. In his house, discipline. And some of you don't like it. Feel you must do what you feel like. And must nobody say anything to me. I am big. Hello? That's right. No guidelines. Do what you want. How you want. Where you want. Don't do anything that comes to your mind. It's not what you do. No. Naturally, we don't do that. Well, this is God's house. In his kingdom, we have just established disciplines, controls, guidelines, teachers, and instructors are the order of God's kingdom. You don't have to see everything. You don't have to believe everything, but what God says is what God says. Hello. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And some, if I don't see it in the Bible, I'm not doing it. I have to read it, chapter, verse, and line. Hello. And if you can't show me that, I'm not going to do it. What a mindset. You're going to have teachers in the house. You will have instructors, and if you have instructors, then it means you're going to get instruction. That's what it means. You're going to be told what you, not me, must do. You're not going to be asked, do you feel like doing this? What do you think about this? God does not make mistakes. When God established a kingdom, he put the person there to run it. He wouldn't even talk to me. And he gives them what they need to get the job done. Hello? And is that based on your choice? Is that who you think is best suited? Is that who you think would do a better job? You're not God, shut up. Hello? Are you with me? Peter was only a fisherman. Rugged and rough. Not the affluent of the society. Smell like fish. Dirty like the seaside. But say, follow me. I'm going to make you fishers of men. Hello? He didn't ask Peter, James, and John. I mean, didn't ask John, Matthew, and all the others, and Dr. Luke. Glory to God. You see, we have a way of going around making choices of people. Oh, this one is mine. This is my. I'm not your preacher. I want you to know tonight, I'm not yours. Oh, this is my preacher. Go ahead and you say, go ahead. Choose your preacher. Hello up in this house. I always like to hear this sister. That's your sister, not God, because she's telling you what you want to hear. Glory. Thank you, Lord. It is God that makes the choice. When Peter declared who he was, he said, Peter, thou art Petrus, your rock. What you just said, the church is going to be established. And what you lose here, Peter, is loose there. What you bind here is bound there. Hello, somebody. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. It's not based on our approval. It's based on God's assignment and his authorization. Amen in this house. Thank you, Jesus. So he's given disciplines, controls, guidelines, amen, and teachers and instructions are the order of God's kingdom. There's going to be always somebody telling you what to do. So get it set in your mind. There's going to be somebody checking you out. You're here? Let me make you mad. There's going to be somebody observing you. Watching what you do. And watching what you're not doing. Whether or not what you're doing, it lining up or has lined up with the word of God, with the instructions given for his kingdom. Amen. Let me say tonight, every home is different. And the way I raise my child, you can raise yours that way. Your child might be just a look. Yes. Might have to get a slap. Yes. Hello, time out don't work. I have to get me something, I go to work. Yes. Hello, that's right. To be spoken to softly. So I've got to draw out the sword and go to work and begin to cut. You are not like that, but that's how it goes. Because there's a charge given to the teacher and the instructor. Yes, sir. I hear God, I love you. He's brought us into his kingdom to discipline us. Amen. To instruct us. Yes. For us to receive guidelines of what he expects from us. If you know to get there, what are you doing here? Why don't you leave right now? What are you doing here? If you have the answer, why are you sitting here? Why did you come?
For the same reason. That's why some don't come. And that's why some hardly come. Because they got it all. Read the other sentence for me. I need glasses. Read. Hold it, hold it. Too fast. Go back again. Those in authority are given to us by whom? Since when do you get the opportunity to choose who you want? And accept and reject. Hello. It's God's kingdom. He does what he wants. He chooses those whom he chooses. And too bad if you and I don't like it. But he placed them where they are to bring balance. Because some of us are lopsided. Some of us are tilted in the wrong direction. Hello. Some of us, the hem is coming out. Hello, somebody. I need somebody to tell you, straighten up. Get it back in line. Get it in a balanced way. Hello. It can't be all of the natural and all of the spiritual. Hello, somebody. You need somebody to tell you, you can't be running on the filthy lucre and God got all of the time from you. You need somebody to tell you that. You need to know that your salvation is not health, wealth, and prosperity. Talk to me. Your salvation is not based on how much you have here. And how much you can achieve here. It's good to achieve, but not at the expense of your soul's salvation. Glory. Some of us are so weak spiritually that we can remember the last time we shout a good hallelujah. Amen. We are so far from God, we can remember the last time we feel a little shake and a quake. The question is the fire gone out? It takes the word of God, if it's good, to fan the flame. I say, takes the word to fan the flame, because this is spiritual. It's not natural. Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. You ask me to show a person that's weak, I'll show you one that hardly come to church. Come on. This is rough stuff. This don't sit too nice and too easy right now. Glory to God. You're more spiritual than natural. Not a soul see a thing. You're more spiritual than you are natural. Amen. This is made up of dust. What about the man that the natural eye cannot see? Where is the balance? Pastor, you can't stay there. Amen. It's not your bread, one butter. Hello? It's not you have raw fish. It's me. If you do what God said do, your bread will be butter. And your fish will be cooked. Let me help us tonight. Hello, somebody. The Bible said, seek ye first. Yes. his kingdom and his righteousness and all these things. It means there is a balance. God, I've done what you said. I'm seeking you first. I've got needs. But I'm going to seek you first. Because you told me this is the way I ought to do it. That's the instruction that God gave. Amen. To seek him first. Yes. So how is it you can hardly be found in the house of God? Oh, I'm sorry. You're out evangelizing. Oh, I'm sorry. You're out soul winning. God, don't you see me out here working for you? Seek ye first. Hello. Bless the name of Jesus. How much time does God get from some of us? Thank you, Lord. How much time do we spend with him? How much do we know about him? The only thing we know that his name is Jesus, and that's it. Know nothing else about him. Hello. There must be a balance. There must be harmony. And there must be growth. And it is sad in this house tonight that some of us are stagnant when it comes to spiritual things. Anywhere they find stagnation, after a while it's going to start to smell. I'm going to help you up in here. If it is stagnant, it means it's dead. There's no life in there. No movement. Nothing that tells you that something is going on. If you stay there long enough, the water going to get black. Anything get inside it going to be poisoned. We'll become contaminated. Hello, God help me. This is why some of us, the people come around us, they become contaminated. Because we have become stagnant when it comes to spiritual things. No growth. Nothing but deadness. No life. Hallelujah. Just going through the motions. How long have you been sitting there? It's like a pool. Water's in there, but it's not good. You can't swim in there. You can't bathe because the water is dead. Glory. Yeah. And for some of us, the more that we hear what God says, is more we do what we feel like. Hello. Good God. Sometimes, Brother Al, that pool stays here until it gets cracked. Mm-hmm. The pool is not cracked. And come like the Bible says, it's like a cistern now. Oh, help me, God. A broken cistern that cannot hold no water. It is poured in, but it runs out. The water go in. But when you go looking for stuff, it's not there. How can we sit in the house of God under the teaching of his word and we still act like a fool? How can we do it? How can we be exposed to the anointing of God but still act like you're dead? Glory! And we think we're so nice in the process too. Glory. If you're not growing, may God help you. If there's no growth, may God of heaven help you. Oh, help me, Jesus. The Bible says he passed by a fig tree one day. Because fig tree ought to have some figs on it. It ought to show life. You better help me up in here. He said, I came looking for food. I found none. It's fig time. It's the season to find figs on the tree. Ah, God. God said, I've dug around you. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. I've dug around you. I put some food on, but I don't see no result of the hard job that I've been doing. Nothing to show for it. Yeah. Help me, Jesus. Has God been wasting his time? Is he doing what he's been doing for nothing? The more you hear, is the farther you get. The more he teaches, is the worse you get. No humility. Hello? No submissiveness to what God demands. God's kingdom is not going to operate the way we think. It's based on his word. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. There must be harmony. There must be balance. Come talk to me. There must be growth. Good God. You plant a tree at the home. You check it, you look for stuff, but God said, listen here, I'm going to curse this. I'm going to curse this fig tree. I want food, there's none. I'm looking for some praises coming out of you, but you're shut up, you're locked up, you're dead. I'm listening to hear some hallelujah with some life. Hallelujah. You say glory, but it's dead, it's dry. Nothing to it. No substance. Glory. I didn't put you here to be a shade tree. I put you here to get some fruit. God is looking for fruit on the tree. Not just fruit, but much fruit. Not just a little bit, but a whole lot. Glory. But say, Lord, Spirit, Spirit, Spirit. Give it another chance. Don't kill it yet. Oh, help me, God. Oh, help me, God. I'm on Satan in this house tonight. For so many, I've been asking God for mercy on your behalf because you become so blatant in your behavior and your reaction when it comes to the things of God. You don't care what you do and how you get it done. And I'm in the house. Ask mercy, Lord, mercy. Please, Lord, before you kill them, show them mercy. When God was getting ready to wipe out Israel, most women said, Lord, spare them. It's not because of you. You're thinking because of your prayer. You are not at the place to pray to God the way you are. Oh, you better help me up in here tonight. Oh, bless the name of Jesus, because you can't go to God with a rebellious approach. And you have not yet repented and submitted and surrendered yourself to God and let God direct what he wants in your life. It's not because of your prayer. Because someone said, mercy, Lord, help them. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Somebody's trying, he's standing the gap for you. Hallelujah. But we said, God, please don't kill them. One more chance. Yet some of you don't want leaders. Now they not be for leaders in your life. You'll be dead already. Glory. I say you'll be dead long time. You'll be buried long time. Hallelujah. But when I pray, I said, God, in your judgment, these are my words. God, in your judgment, remember mercy. Yes. Glory. Hallelujah, somebody. Glory. What do we do with what God has given us? Last year, this same time, no fruit. The year before, same time, no fruit. This new year, 2014, still no fruit. None. How much longer do we think God's going to keep up this with us in our jungle or mess? Hello. That's right. How much longer do we think he's going to remain in that merciful mode? And think because, amen, God is a God of grace. He's long-suffering. He's tender-hearted. His patience run out sometimes. Glory. He said, I'm going to give it one more chance. Oh, God, I don't know who this is for. But God said, I'm going to give you one more chance. You've been exposed tonight one more time to the word of God, to the instruction that I'm sending in the kingdom for you and for you and for you and for me. And one more chance. He said, I'm going to come back again. I'm going to check the tree. God said, if I find no fruits, then son, he must be hewn down. Yeah, and be cast in the fiery furnace. Glory to the name of Jesus. Don't fool with God. Don't think that God is like your buddy. He got to put up with your junk. He doesn't have to. Hallelujah, somebody. We do what we want, how we want, when we want, where we want, and can nobody say anything? Glory. Because for some of us tonight, after you leave, I mightn't see you again until when you feel again. You're digging your grave. Oh, yes, you are. Pastor, you can't talk that. Yes, I can. Even though is the axe laid at the root of the tree. This is Bible. The axe is at the root of the tree. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Help me, God. Want us to give me the space to say what I'm saying. Glory. When I enter some realm, you better don't get up in there with me. Hallelujah, somebody. He has been patient. Long-suffering. Yes. Hallelujah. He's been warning. He's been letting us know that this kingdom is his. And how we ought to operate in his kingdom. This is not your house. This is not your address where you live. Glory to the name of, and we keep on strutting our mess before God. And think God is He's blind, he can't see. Hallelujah. He's deaf and he can't hear. Hallelujah. A place for a place in my kingdom, even in this house, for your soul's salvation. Hallelujah. let me say it tonight. It don't matter if you leave from here and go to Timbuktu. You heard what you heard already. It means God wants you to hear some stuff. And you're not free. You're not free. There's a reason why God brought you up in here. To deliver certain instructions to you. For you to abide by it. These are not my rules. But it's a voice of God that speaks. Hallelujah. You better slow down. Hello, somebody. Get in harmony with God. Hallelujah. Because God gonna require some things at your hand. What we find today, when God speaks and I'm going to stop, instead of complying, we criticize what God says. We talk against what God says. Because we think we're above what he's saying. And what is being said is not meant for you. Since when you become God special? But he didn't include you in what he's saying. Hello. Balance, harmony, growth. Parents, kings, governors, rulers, and masters are all have a scriptural position and role to fill. I'm going to help you tonight. Lord Ross is no mistake. In your life, I'm no mistake. In this house, I'm no mistake. In your life, this is not a butt up. Hello. This is not God couldn't find nobody else. Hello. I got news for you. He knew who he was looking for. So he brought him from the island. Because he saw you coming to Connecticut. Hello. So I told him. I came for one thing, but he switched it. Because he saw you. And God knew that you would need a straight talker like me. That's why one that don't beat on no hedge. But get you mad enough to either do right or do wrong. Hello, somebody. But hear me. Everything that God has put in his kingdom, every position he's filled in his kingdom, is for our purpose. It's for our reasons. You need guidelines. You need control. You need discipline. I got a bunch of sinners up in here. Y'all don't touch this. Leave this alone. Y'all don't butt into this. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. I see a bunch of sinners. Only dressed up. Look like, talk like, speak like, shout like, but in their heart they are far from God. No desire to do what's right. But you're not getting away. You're not getting away. I have come to the kingdom. For such a time as this. I've been placed in God's kingdom for such a time as this. Glory. It's for the saving of souls. It's for lives to be brought in harmony with God. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. Amen. And what you think or what you say will not change what God put in place. Help me tonight, God. Are you in God's kingdom? Or are you in the devil's kingdom? Who is it you're taking instructions from? Because obviously somebody's talking to you. Boy, now check it out. It don't line up with the word. Hallelujah. We might try to hide, but only for a while. We will be exposed. The book says, our sin is going to find us out. Hallelujah. God, hit me tonight. Not just to be a teacher of the word, but a liver of it. Not just to speak it, but to live it. Hello, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of us need to repent tonight before God and ask God for forgiveness. And ask God, please, God, forgive me of all the errors that I have created and have made. I've done some stupid stuff, Lord. Forgive me. You give me one more chance, I'm going to seize it. I'm going to grab hold to it. I will not leave from his house tonight. Act as if I'm right when I know I'm wrong. Glory. Glory. Yeah. Hallelujah. Kelo Shando. Glory to the name of Jesus. Glory. Before we call this quits, shift this to the side, Dick. God saw us coming. That's why he delivered in this house tonight, in this man, in this way. If you think I'm going to beg you to do anything, you can sit down right there.